Hi everyone, this is Nick. Today I'm going to show you how to update your color theme in your Microsoft Excel document or workbook. So we all know that Microsoft has wonderful default color themes, but we don't always want to use those. We want to use our own custom brand colors. Otherwise, people will always know that you are just using Microsoft's stock default colors. And I'm going to show you how to do that inside of Microsoft Excel. So right here on this top row, you can see this is the default color palette that Microsoft, it's actually a newer color palette that Microsoft rolled out the Office theme over this past year. So it's kind of this blue, orange, green. We have six accent colors to choose from in any Microsoft Office palette. This row right here, this is gonna be my new custom brand palette that I wanna update my document to. And you can see here, I have a chart down here that pulls from each of those main six accent colors because I want you to see how those can be updated inside of Microsoft Excel just automatically. So all we need to do, you're gonna be probably right here on the Home tab when you open your Excel workbook. But what you're gonna do is go to the Page Layout tab up here on the ribbon, and then over here in the Theme menu, you can see that we have our color drop down. Now, when you drop down the colors, you are going to have all of these different office themes. They give us a lot of different sort of stock color palettes that we might want to choose from. Right now, we're up here at the top office palette. If we wanted the 2013 to 2022 palette, we could hover over that, and you can see how everything updates in my chart and in that top row of boxes. Now, my custom brand colors don't update because those are custom colors that I programmed in to the workbook already. So what we're gonna do if we want to update this office theme is we're gonna go down here to customize colors. And the customize, the theme color menu is gonna pop up right here. And you can see now we have all of our accents, accent one through accent six. Now I'm gonna go ahead and take, first I'm actually going to, let's see, I can see that I have all of my hex codes, my hex values. These are the color values that I wanna update to. So this first accent color, I'm gonna click on this, and then you're gonna click on more colors. Now in order to update this then, we're gonna go ahead and type in the value there, 156082. We're gonna push okay. And now that has updated our first accent color. It's really similar to that office theme, and that's okay. These blues and oranges are really nice colors to have anyway. This next color here, we're gonna go on to accent two. I'm gonna click on more colors. We're gonna go ahead and type in that value, A50050. And I'm gonna click OK, and that's gonna update our accent number two. Now I'm gonna go do that for the rest of the accents. There's my green, 358629, OK. And my accent four is gonna be this other sort of lighter shade of blue, A8, click OK. We're gonna go down to accent number five, and do the same process over and over and over again until all of your colors have been updated. It's gonna be that orange. And then our number six is gonna be the shade of purple. 500878. All right, we're gonna click OK. And now right here under name, you can name your custom palette. So I'm gonna go ahead and just say Nick's brand palette, and we're gonna click OK. Now you can see that both of these squares, both of these sets of squares have updated because I've updated the custom colors, and my chart colors have also updated too because each of these bars is pulling from one of those top accent colors. And so that's kind of how you can make your workbook just a little bit more dynamic. Now if I wanted to open a new Excel workbook, all I would have to do is go up to Page Layout, and since I saved that custom palette, I should see that in my custom palettes. Now, I have a whole bunch of them here, but I'm going to go right here. You can see Nick's brand palette, and I'm going to change that, and now anytime I insert a chart or a shape, it's going to immediately pull from all of those colors in my custom palette. You can see under Shape Styles here, you can apply those different colors to different shapes, chart objects, text, anything you want to in your workbook. So that's a really quick way that you can go ahead and update your your color palette inside of Microsoft Excel and look like a pro, because now you're not using Microsoft's default colors, you're using your own custom brand palette. If you like this video, I hope you give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. I had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you next time.